saw some dogs chasing this rabbit. I saw dogs chasing this rabbit. Saw a dog that's chasing this rabbit is on Sunday about noon. I said to the rabbit, you're gonna make it. I said to the rabbit, are you gonna make it? I said to the rabbit, you're gonna make it. The rabbit said, well, I got to. You get it? Well, a woman's sight's a sacred thing. Woman's sight's a sacred thing. Woman's sight's a sacred thing. What's a man to do? Try a little tenderness, so this Reddit said. Try a little tenderness is what it said. Try a little tenderness, so this said. And then it said, I got to, got to. Now there's two kind of people in the world. There's two kind of people in the world. There's two kind of people in the world. The day people and the night people. And it's the night people's job. It's the night people's job. It's the night people's job to get the day people's money. Well, between the devil and the deep blue sea, between the devil and the deep blue sea, between the devil and the deep blue sea, that's where I am. I don't know what that means. Maybe it means I'm fucking cool. Maybe it means I'm fucking cool. Maybe it means I'm fucking cool. Maybe it means I'm in Port Aransas, Texas. Everybody loves it. If it's in the groove, everybody loves it. If it's in the groove, everybody loves it. The great Howlin' Wolf said that. We've a short time to be here. We've a short time to be here. We've a short time to be here. So get out of your rut and let's get in the groove. Get out of them ruts, let's get in the groove. If you're in a rut, get out of it. Ready for this? We'll see you all. Yeah. Well, a woman I love is named Ramona. She kind of looks like a tempest storm. She can dance like a little Egypt. She works down the snake farm, snake farm. It just sounds nasty, snake farm. It pretty much is snake farm. It's a reptile house, snake farm. Ramona's got a keen sense of humor. She got a tattoo down her arm. It's of a python eating a little mouse, wearing a sailor hat that says snake farm. Snake farm, it just sounds nasty. Snake farm, it pretty much is snake farm. It's a reptile house, snake farm. Said, well, it's got its charm. There's nothing to do in the winter. And now that some kid gets bit at the snake farm. Oh, snake farm. It just sounds nasty. Snake farm. It pretty much is snake farm. It's a reptile house, snake farm. Thank you. something. Yeah. This is a sing-along. Yeah. Really, really is. You go State Farm, it just sounds nasty.
State Farm, it pretty much is. State Farm,
it's a reptile house.
State Farm.
It ain't exactly kumbaya, but looking at you, it's more appropriate. Right? Help me now. I said, Snake Farm, it just sounds nasty.
Snake Farm, it pretty much is. Snake Farm,
it's a reptile house.
Snake Farm.
That's called the alarm. She said she cried when they broke up. Still plays a regular there, the Snake Farm.
Snake Farm, it just sounds nasty.
Snake Farm,
it pretty much is.
Snake Farm, it's a reptile house.
Snake Farm.
Ooh. Christmas at the Snake Farm, but nobody's celebrating. You see, it's winter at the Snake Farm. Snakes are hibernating.
Snake Farm, it just sounds nasty.
Snake Farm,
it pretty much is.
Snake Farm, it's a reptile house.
Snake Farm,
last chance.
Snake Farm, it just sounds nasty.
Snake Farm.
Take this opportunity to introduce the band on the cajon, the snare drum, and a bunch of stuff he found in a dumpster. He just pounded on that right there is Kyle Snyder from Austin, Texas. Okay, he's here. And over there on the guitar, that's my son Lucas over on the guitar. And what a large crowd. This is obviously the first time that a number of you have appeared before me.
Yeah.
So I would imagine after the first two songs, you're a little nervous. What is this? But I just pretty much write these songs and talk about them. I wrote this next song here with a young guy named Hayes Carl.
Cigarettes and papers and Oreos.
she danced with the dead at the pyramids. I'm gonna holler and I'm gonna scream. I'm gonna give me some mescaline, and then I'm gonna rhyme out with gasoline to drunk a boy's dream. Whoa, whoa. I'll never pay back my student loan.
Yeah.
Hayes wrote that line. Smelling like Coors and cheap cologne. She tells me not to worry about Judgment Day. She says down to getting to heaven just ain't our way. I'm gonna holler and I'm gonna scream. I'm gonna give me some mescaline. Song up, and Hayes put it on an album. Came out about 10 years ago and won a bunch of awards and everything. Well, you think that's funny? Wait till I get to the punchline.
Yeah.
Maybe you should sit near the bathroom.
Yeah.
So won a bunch of awards. I put it on an album, came out 8 years ago, came out. The title of the album was A Enlightenment, B Endarkenment, hint, there is no C. Now, it's the worst title there's ever been for an album. A lot of music journalists let me know that. It's got this really creepy picture on the front of the album. I got my head cut off. I'm holding my own head in my own hand. I mean, I got on a pretty dapper suit. But still, you show it to little kids, it kind of scares them out. So it's got a horrible title and a creepy picture. So you've got to be asking, going, Ray, why would you do that?
Ray, why would you do that?
Almost in unison. It seemed like you all want to know it, except for one person just randomly wants to know it. Well, I'll tell you, I finally figured out you get more attention by burning down the barn than you do carrying out the trash. If this should be the first time you've ever seen me perform, you've probably come to the conclusion that I am an acquired taste. And I am not for everyone. And this next song here should weed you out. Young man about 20. 41 years old, y'all. All I wanted was a stripper girlfriend and a gold top Les Paul. Be careful of the things you wish for, you might get them. There was a nightclub in Dallas. It was called Mother Blues. It's where Lightning Hopkins played and Freddie King even paid some dues. And all the dealers and gamblers and young white hoodsters, they all made the scene. A girl at the door who checked IDs was just sustained. It was not a place for law-abiding citizens. Now Jackie Jones, he had him a habit. He just couldn't stop. They gave me $500. I say I'm a Les Paul gold top. I drove my daddy's car down to Ross Avenue and I sold it. Should have told him, he alluded to the police and someone stole it. It was just the first of many bad decisions I was to make for the next 20 years. But I had me a guitar. This is the first song that I learned on it. This thing that a lot of people know about, especially musicians, is called After Hours. And now what that is the real nightlife begins after the clubs close. At 2 a.m. and everybody's gone, but the band, the dealers, and Jack Jones. Then the girls from the Landing Strip Club come over after they put the clothes back on. So I'm Mama Blues and I'm sitting on an amp. I'm playing Twist and Shout. And this tall, a drink of water walk in, looked like she might have to shoot her way out. She come up to me, she said, "You know anything good on that guitar?" I didn't say nothing, I just kept playing. She said, "You ever heard this song called Poke Salad Annie?" I just kept playing. She said, "Every time I hear that song, my insides feel like warm butter. I just want to take off my clothes and dance around in my underwear." I said, "Down in Louisiana, where the alligator boys are mean." Sean, thank you, Tony Joe. That's all I knew of it. But it was enough. She was a woman of a word, gal. So me and this dancer, we hit it off. We hit it off like a metaphor for a hydrogen bomb. We was enriched uranium, supercritical mass. We was a chain reaction. It wasn't love and lust. It's mostly lust, but it's a mutual attraction. So there I was, boys, at 21 years old. I had it all. I had a fine stripper girlfriend and a gold top Les Paul. The future, what were the promising? But there were dark clouds on the horizon. She was a beautiful girl, but she liked to drink a lot of tequila. Yeah, that ain't all. I come home 4 or 5 times, and she had called my Les Paul. So we broke up, and she went to Hollywood. She married her an actor. She got a job dancing on the Hudson Brothers TV show and modeling lipstick for Max Factor. I'm glad she'd done all right. I got over her eventually. I am glad she'd done all right. Well, damn me, you know, I never really busted through the gates into the big, big time as a rock and roll star. For 40 years, I just carried around an old gold-top guitar. But love and fate are mysterious things in this funky old world. It was 33 years ago I ended up marrying that Mother Blues door girl. We had us a boy, that's him over there, playing guitar. I don't know if Lucas is gonna hang his life on a guitar. It's a hard old road, you know. Not every gig or audience is as good as this one. But I'm very, very grateful for the time I get to share the stage with my son. Very, very grateful that Kyle Snyder's here tonight, yeah, laying down a groove that you could hammer nails on. Yeah. I say, man, I'm old cat. I've been doing this for a long, long time, but I'm extremely grateful that I'm still writing songs, and I'm very grateful I'm able to travel around and play them for people. And I'm extremely grateful that people will come out and hear me play these old songs that I wrote. You know, the days that I keep my gratitude higher than my expectations. I have really good days, and I wasn't expecting all you people, but today is a damn fine day. I might say so myself. A true story, my wife Judy was a door girl at Mother Blues. She was 16 after she had run away from home or got kicked out, whichever story you want to hear. And I didn't really know her back then and everything. And the girl in the song, the dancer and everything, she actually left and went. There was a TV show called the Hudson Brothers TV show, which was the summer replacement show for the Sonny and Cher show for one summer. And she got a job dancing on that. She married this actor out there. And we stay in touch. We really do. Every 2 years, she sends me a picture of her and her new Lexus. I get that dig, but speaking of my wife Judy, now we actually wrote this next song. What happened was, I had this gig, and it was a rough gig, man. It was just a rowdy, wild crowd, and the sound, like Ray back here makes this sound, and he knows what he's doing. The sound at this gig was really rough, and the promoter was kind of sketchy. And you all right back there? And like I say, I don't know if you know this or not, but I have a gift. During that first song I come out here, the rabbit, we're about to talk about the dog chasing rabbit. As I'm playing and singing that song, you know, somewhere over here in my head, I have the ability to count the number of people in the audience, multiply that by the cover charge, and take 80%. We don't really ain't gonna be doing any blues tonight, boys. So anyhow, I got back from this gig, and my wife Judy goes, "How was the gig?" I said, "Man, it was a rough gig. The sound was all feedbacky, and the promoter was sketchy, and everything." And she and I said, "It was really." She said, "Well, everybody turns a bad trick every now and then." So anyhow, we wrote this. Soda don't always remove ketchup stains. Ain't nothing you everybody turns a bad trick now and then. You got to have some scars if you want to be a poet. To get weeds out of a garden, you got to hoe it. Possession with intent will get you 5 to 10. And everybody turns a bad trick now and then. And everybody turns a bad trick now and then. Most gamblers know that they'll never break even, and there's 5 stages to go through when you're graving. The sword is always bloodier than the pen, and everybody turns a bad trick now and then. You got to have some scars if you wanna be a poet. To get weeds out of a garden, you got to hoe it. Possession with intent will get you 5 to 10. And everybody turns a bad trick now and then. And everybody turns a bad trick now and then. Dancing is promiscuous if it's after midnight, and it's better to be content than have to always be right. You can't fix a broken heart with a bobby pin, and everybody turns a bad trick now and then. You got to have some scars if you want to be a poet. To get weeds out of a garden, you got to hoe it. Possession with intent will get you 5 to 10. And everybody turns a bad trick now and then. Everybody turns a bad trick now and then. Tell you something now that stays here. We don't tell anybody who wasn't here tonight. This is a trust. We have a trust. We have a bond. I know what I'm gonna say. I thought we were just doing a trio tonight. We have a trust thing here. Like priest confessional. You people wouldn't understand that. Lawyer client. Well, you can't tell on me. When I found out that Ringo Starr was going to play drums on this track, about 5 years ago, I got this text from Ringo. He said, be out in L.A. next Tuesday, and I'll play drums on track. So I flew out there by myself, and Judy and I had written the song. But on the way out there, I'm going, man, I got a beetle on this thing. And then, so I left those 2 measures where there's nothing. They're just two rest measures just to see if he would do the fill from Get Back. So you're gonna have to buy the album to find out. It's pretty close. So I went out there and it was pretty good. Like I say, he lives in Beverly Hills, but it's not a big mansion. It's just a 1-story cool house and everything. So I'm just out there and it's just like Ringo and Bruce Sugar is engineer and me, we're just in this little place doing it. And it's really difficult because all of a sudden you're on my whatever, somewhere over in your head, you're going, it's a beetle, man. And so we finished the track, and he said, who are you going to get to play bass? And I said, I don't know. And he said, how about Don Was? And I said, I don't know Don Was. He said, I'll ask him. He said, who's going to play guitar? And I said, well, I really don't know. He said, how about my brother-in-law, Joe Walsh? And I said, okay, well, what do you hear the story later? And so at that point, Then I called up Chris Robbins and I said, look, man, I got a Beelan Eagle. I need a crow. And lo and behold, he said yes in some funky place and he said, please do so for us. And so anyhow, I feel very fortunate that that happened. So anyhow, the album I did before co-starring is called Tell the Devil I'm Getting There As Fast As I Can, which is meant to be taken metaphorically, you know, like I'm an old cat, just old smart ass. Somebody says, hey, Hubbard, you're getting old. And you go, well, tell the devil I'm getting there as fast as I can, which hopefully it's metaphorically rather than a prophecy. But it's not really a concept album, but there's a theme that runs through a couple of songs there. And that theme is, I mentioned I'm an old cat. You get to be my age, you start thinking about your mortality. So there's a couple of songs on the album where the idea is I hope God grades on a curve. You know, I'm not Mother Teresa, but hey, man, I'm not a Tillamook hun. So maybe a C minus. Maybe a C minus won't get me into heaven proper, but maybe it'll get me in some sort of celestial vocational night school. Work in the ninth grade. So anyhow, this is a little what I would like to refer to as a rock and roll fable. Troublesome back and a ringing in a ear. My last band covered the Clash, the Kinks, and the Replacements. Seems my soul is as misspent as my year. I got a Princeton reverb, it's in an old envelope case. In the back of a Ford Econoline. It is a 6-hour drive to Austin and the Continental Club. I gotta change the strings on my ES-335. Tell the devil that I'm getting there as fast as I. In this old guitar, in this alt country band, and loving a woman who can't curse any man. Tell the devil that I'm getting there as fast as I can. I met her in L.A. We were opening for Sunvolt. She had eyes mascaraed up like Eva Green. She sparkled with wildness like the blue yonder. She'd done a time in darkness and was 2 years clean. She wears an old leather jacket that was made by Iris. Skulls and thorns. She got a rink in Tulsa, but she don't like them red dirt bands. Being in love with her, it's like living in a thunderstorm. Tell the devil that I'm getting there as fast as I can. In this old country band, and loving a woman who can outcuss any man. Tell the devil that I'm getting there as fast as I can. faithless living grays and faded purples. And the gamblers never bet on 12s or 2s. The drunken poets disappear into their own shadows. And the rock and roll believers sing the Easy Rider blues. Tell the devil that I'm getting there as fast as I can. Playing this old guitar in this old country band. And loving a woman who got